Okay, now we're looking at number 20 in section 2.4, and we've got f of x is equal to that what we call the greatest integer function. And this is a good one to look at on your calculator. When you look at that function, in order to get it to work on your calculator, it's under the math. Let me get up in here. I did it in y equals, so in math, and then if I go to num, it's choice 5. And then I can do x. And I'll just look in the standard viewing window. And it's a step function. And for numbers between 0 and right up to 1, it returns 0. So 0.999, the greatest integer of 0.999 is 0. And then from 1 to 1.999999, or as close as you can get to 2 without being 2, it returns a value of 1. So that's what you want to think about, what that graph looks like. And so you can kind of, it's a nice way to think about the limit. So if you want to think about the limit as x approaches 0 from the left, what kind of numbers are you going to get? Well, here we are approaching 0 from the left, we actually get negative 1. But the limit as x approaches 0 from the right is going to be 0. And the function value f at 0 is actually 0. And you can verify that with your calculator if you come in here and just do math and then over to num and then choice 5 for 0, you will get 0. But if you did that, you can do second entry and pull it up again. Like say you did 1.5, the greatest integer it's the greatest integer equal to or less than 1.5, and so that's going to return 1. So what happens is we can say that these functions are right continuous because as you come in from the right of the number, you will get, so it's right, this function is right continuous at integer values of x. So we'll say it has, and it has definitely jump discontinuities. At integer values of x, and it is right continuous there, and is right continuous at integer values of x.